नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। स्टैंडर्ड 10th सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर 11, द ह्यूमन आई एंड द कलरफुल वर्ल्ड। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी डिस्कस हाइपरमेट्रोपिया। सी द स्पेलिंग इज स्कूल ऑफ मायोपिया इज वेरी स्मॉल, सो दिस इज वेरी थिंग near-sightedness, I told you, to easily you can remember. But here you see, the spelling is long, so we can say that far-sightedness. Okay? This far-sightedness, hypermetropia, is also called as far-sightedness. So here, a person with hypermetropia can see the distant objects clearly. Distance means distant, far objects clearly, but cannot see the near objects distinctly. So what happens? The near point for the person is the ear. The near point becomes far. See, the near point for the person is farther away from the normal near point, 25 centimeters. Actually, the person has to read like this, but here near point becomes farther. So, near point, far, becomes far. So, that is why such a person has to keep a reading material much beyond 25 centimeters from the eye. So much beyond from the eye for comfortable reading. Okay, why it happens? So this is because of the light rays from a closely object are focused at a point behind the retina. See here, the light rays are focused at a point behind the retina. So that is it. Okay. So this defect arises of two main points. So one is the focal length of the eye lens is too long. And the second point is the eyeball has become too small. See, the eyeball has becoming too small. Okay. So this defect can be corrected by, so how you can correct it, this defect? By using the convex lens. So you know that, how you can remember this, the convex lens. See, suppose this one, very far. So this way, far-sightedness. So, convex lens. So, what lens is this? Convex lens. Now, dear students, see that diagram. So, what the diagram says, the far point where you see, this is the near point of hypermetropic eye. See, this one is the near point of the hypermetropic eye. See, this one is not the normal eye mode. This actually the object is here. See, from here, if you are looking, you will get this, right? What it happens? The image behind it will be there. See, this one is the near point of the hypermetropic eye. So objects will be becomes far here, far, so that this image falls on this. Suppose as usual eye will be there, what happens? If the object is here from the normal here, then the person cannot see that. So what will happen? The image will fall behind the retina. So that is why you are saying. So, image will fall, what will be there? behind the ultrasound X-ray are saying farsightedness. And so you are saying here farsightedness. Okay, so that's why you are saying far. See, actually the person has to look here, but he cannot see properly. So he's because his point here, near sightedness changes and becomes far. So from here, if you see here, from this place, okay, then only the image falls on the retina. Got the idea, students? See now, this one is how can be corrected, how it can be corrected by this. So this can be corrected by using the convex lens. So farsightedness can be corrected by the using the convex lens. Know that here the far, okay. So when you will place this convex lens here, so what will happen? This image will fall here, the image will fall here. See, when you are placing the convex lens, the image of this falls here far. Actually, the object is not here, but the image falls here. But the eye thought that the object is here instead of here, the eye thought that here. So that's why this image falls on the retina. So then the person can see the things or the object easily or clearly. Okay, what are the ideas we will see? This is not here, this. By using the convex lens, the image falls, this image falls here. The far, here it falls. So I thought that the object is not this, I thought that this is the object. So that one, the image falls on this retina. So in this way, farsightedness can be corrected by using the convex lens. So eyeglasses with converging lenses provide the additional focusing. See, the eyeglasses with the converging lenses provide the additional focusing power, additional focusing power required for forming the image on the retina. To form the image on the retina, so what will be required? Eyeglasses with converging lens will be required for this. Okay, students, see. So, learn that what is hypermetropia? Hypermetropia means farsightedness. So here, the farsightedness will be there. The persons can see the things, the objects far properly. But he has the problem of the near. You know that distance, the adult, clearly, you can see that only the, for the adult 25 centimeters. So, the near point for the person is farther away from the normal. So it becomes farther from the normal. Okay, students? Dear students, now we discuss presbyopia. See the screen. PRESBYOPIA. Presbyopia. Okay. So here, what do you mean by presbyopia? This another name is there. Old age, old eye. Because this usually the presbyopia comes after the age, after 40, crossing, then the some of the persons or the diseases of presbyopia. Diseases means here defect. Defect means here disease. Something don't misunderstand. So eye defect means eye disease. See, this presbyopia, how it happens? You know that after the age, the eye lens becomes, what it becomes? The eye lens. That extension that becomes less. or diminishing. So due to the iron's diminishing, the power of accommodation also decreases. Okay. So this power of accommodation of the eye usually decreases with aging. So why it happens? The power of the accommodation of the eye usually decreases with the aging. With the aging, the power of the accommodation will be decreasing. For most of the people, the near point gradually recedes away, recedes, move away. The person, they can't read the nearer. So they have to hold it very far. So they find it difficult to see the nearby the objects comfortably and distinctly. Comfortably and distinctly. And also properly, you are saying, you know. So that is why the persons, this defect is comfortably and distinctly without corrective eyeglasses. So this diseases, yes, this defect we are calling the presbyopia. Okay? So sometimes asking the question, so after the age, what are the diseases is causing? So then you have to say that, or you have to remember that presbyopia. So this is the defect, or this is the disease usually the aged person. Aged means after 40 all. Okay. This defect is arises due to the gradual weakness. See, gradual weakening of the ciliary muscles. So this defect will be causes due to the weakness of ciliary muscles. You know that eye lens is what? Regulated by the ciliary muscles. So this eye lens, what adjustment, when it loses, so what will be there, you will see, it arises due to the gradual weakening of the ciliary muscles and also diminishing flexibility of the eye lens, diminishing, becomes less the flexibility of the eyes. So eye lens flexibility becomes, diminishes, becomes less. So due to this, the presbyopia will be happening. So the such people sometimes a person may suffer from, see, some of the persons may suffer from both myopia as well as hypermetropia. Myopia means you are knowing nearsightedness, and hypermetropia means farsightedness. See, for some of the persons may cause the difficulty of both myopia as well as hypermetropia. So such people often require bifocal lenses. So what they have to do, they have to wear both the lenses, convex lens and concave lens, both bifocal lens. So they have to go for. A common type of bifocal lenses consists of both concave and convex lens. See that common type of bifocal lens consists of both concave and as well as convex lens. Concave lens as well as convex lens. The upper portion consists of the concave lens. See, this is here. The upper portion will be, so both lenses will be there. The upper portion of the upper portion consists of concave lens. It facilitates distinct vision, distant, far vision. So the person can see the far vision. The lower part is a convex lens. See, the lower part, what will be there? Convex lens. It facilitates near vision. So what will happen? It facilitates it. It facilitates the near vision. So, these days, it is possible to correct the refractive defects with contact lenses. refractive defects, or you can say that the dissimilar defects with the contact lenses or through the surgical interventions. So nowadays, to possible for the correction by this type of defects by using the contact lenses or through the surgical interventions. Okay, students. So what the idea about the press myopia? Okay. Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you for joining us.